Park my car here in the quite nice little village of Jan Vaya, and there's some old-fashioned cottages in this village. There's a former chapel now converted into a house, the village bus stop, and the car park today is full, so I had to park on the side of the road. There's a busy main road just a few yards away, but I'm on a quiet village street here, and all these cars are parked in this car park. There must be some kind of a meeting in the village hall. Progressing up the lane that leads, well, this is Jan Vaya. There's a suburban, typical suburban side street, and further down there's some council houses on the left-hand side, and continue up here to the crossroads and then turn right. Over there is Shell Island. The sun has gone in at this particular location. But here, this is the Hunt Dewey Way. Runs here, and there's a post office letterbox. The letterbox and a nice little bus stop shelter. It serves both sides of the roads, and I could turn up here, continue uphill and above Jan Vaya, curves around to the right. There's a traditional Welsh house there, now converted to a bed and breakfast. Quite nice houses along the side of this, well, it's a cul-de-sac, and this old house here looks as though it once a rectory cottage. And there is a church down in the village, so he presumably had to walk to the church. The rector at one time may have gained a couple of hundred feet in height, still some height to gain, and the views start to, well, I won't be able to see anything with that line of hawthorn trees, but the views start to improve as I get higher up. These cottages here have a good view, overlooking, well, that's down Hand Danwig down there, where I go several times for a beach walk each week, and of course Shell Island. And St. Patrick's Causeway apparently can be seen occasionally from up here, but no sign of it. No sign of it now. The make another turning here at this junction. Looks like this is a nice little campsite. And normally when I come up here, there's no one here, but it's still early September, so there's still a few people on holidays. And over there is the Rinnegs. And the palm here. So I'll go down this tarmac lane and I'll come into another farm. Penn's Farm. That's the, well, I presume it's a farm still, but there are some outbuildings. I have basically walking the public right away, I think, does go through this private property, and these stone steps you can see on the left here, they were used at one time for loading in hay or whatever into the barn. Came through the farm and someone's burning a bit of rubbish, but no problem, that goes with the territory. There's a fairly defined footpath. path going this far, but when I go a little bit further along, I've always had trouble finding an actual public right of way. It looks like, well, this looks like it's signposted nicely. And Rinnocks in the back are in sunshine. So, looks like I go this way. Let's go, this isn't too bad. But it's just slightly off the beaten track, and here's a little ditch which has a stone bridge, and quite a nice little style here. So far so good. You can see the burial chamber about a quarter of a mile away by a ruined barn. And I think the right of way goes across this, well, very rough semi-marshland. There's a fairly clear path that goes down here, but that leads away from the burial chamber. I'll just see if I can pick up that. There are some slabs down hidden under that long grass or rough pasture, really, across the rough ground. And there is a very somewhat indistinct but recognizable path. People have forged a way through there. All right, I'm just over there, a couple of fields, just two fields away, is that burial chamber through the gate there just a few moments ago. And this is an iron gate here which seems to bar the way, but it doesn't catch the eye right away. But there's a nice little stone stile here which serves the purpose, proof positive it is a right away. I think I missed another stone stile just around the corner there and ended up on the other side of that wall, which meant I had to climb over another couple of iron gates. There's the burial chamber. It's quite an impressive one. And let's see. I don't think it's very well visited because there's the iron gates, but nothing really, and no clear footpaths to get here, but it's quite a substantial capstone, and at one time, of course, yes, some ancient chieftain was buried here. The present Rinnocks at the burial chamber. Oh, the public right away goes down here, and I might just turn up and just walk up to those storage silos. Just a short diversion. Take a shortcut to this tarmac lane. But of course the farmer, this isn't actually a right of way, so the farmer will discourage walkers from using this gate. There's the storage silos. So I'll just go down here a little while, and I will get a little way, and then I'll get to the authorized right away there. But originally the storage silos are just up there, but here's the authorized right away here. So only 30-40 feet drop in altitude. So there's some geese. The reason I came up here was this little cottage, which went out here in the middle of nowhere, and there's the storage silos. I don't think they're any longer used, but quite impressive structures and rather a surreal sight here in the basically the middle of nowhere. And so I'll retrace my steps and go down this tarmac lane towards Pensar. I'm a few yards up that tarmac lane just to highlight this outdoor education center. Welcome to Briny Mall, CMC Adventure since 1966. So the center is up there, not too far, but I won't be going that way. And there's the little stream that runs down this valley. Okay, I've almost descended back down to sea level again. And I haven't got this part of a walk, this walk anyway, already on a previous video. So I'll go down here, another 100 yards or so, and then turn right and climb uphill again. Turn off and go up this somewhat steep hill, tarmacked for the first way, and then goes into a rough footpath. There's an attractive hillside. Oh, it's a house, rather than just a cottage. And may need a paint job or some work done on it. It's a lot of these properties. And here's another very nice house. Just here, can't quite see it, but what we can see is the entrance driveway. But it's got some very nice trees on the property, especially a little bit further down. The actual road ends where this house serves this house, and then I go through there, through that gate, where the clematis over the top of it. I go through whoever lives in that house, a lady I believe. I go through her front lawn, and she does have a good view over towards Shell Island. There's the gates. Gone through the front yard. That's no public right of way, but there's a nice greenhouse. And I go this way, section of the walk. There's a footpath here, but it's not very well trodden. But in the winter this can be a bit muddy, because the farmer keeps his cattle here, but they're pretty docile creatures. The unfrequented, or rarely frequented footpath, but it does lead to one of the interesting parts of this walk. This is Jan Vyer Pet Farm, and of course just up the hill a bit is Jan Vyer Slate Caverns, which I won't be seeing today. But this has an end of season look about it. 4th of September. This pet farm, the animals are kept in these buildings and kept there basically, I think, throughout the winter. There's the entrance to the pet farm, and the Jan Vyer cabins are a little way up there, but I'll be going off to the left here along this footpath, the end of this walk now. But there's the slate, the disused slate that came out of the Jan Vyer slate caverns or workings. And of course Pensarm Harbour was constructed. It's probably a busy industrial district at one time. So I'll be going across this field and then into the village of, my car is up there, is the little village of Yanbaya. Now on this walk, I'll just go in and see the village church. I don't normally, St. Mary's, I don't normally go into churches on my walks, but I can't go inside, but I'll just have a little walk around. It's unlocked. And it's the first time I've been in here. That looks like an ancient font. It is very dark in here, but luckily this camera is very good in dark, well, at night time, basically, not much. I'll just go up to the altar, and this church has probably, there's the stone pulpit. No, very little about this church. Unfortunately, I didn't bring any change with me, because I ought to make a small donation each time I enter into this church. Can't quite see the stained glass windows, but yes, it is an interesting old church, this. I'll when I get back, I'll look up on the internet, and someone who buried there, Ellis Wynne, in 1734. Final picture of the exterior of the church, and some of the gravestones. Most of the gravestones are around 19th century. Concrete path here that runs to a more up-to-date cemetery at the back. Okay, that's the end of this walk, and return to the car.